Hey, what's up, you guys? Marty Schwartz here. I'm a guitar teacher. I have a YouTube channel called Marty Music. Today, we're going to learn 5 different ways to play House of the Rising Sun with rising levels of difficulty. Now, this song's great for beginners because it uses 5 of the most basic open chords. A lot of different people have covered it. It's actually, though, an old traditional folk song, also sometimes known as Rising Sun Blues. The most famous version of it is by the band The Animals, but it goes way, way back.
There is a house in New Orleans. They call the rising sun.
It's almost got a similarity to like a sea chanty kind of vibe. It's in a time signature of 3. So you're counting in 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. That 1, 2, 3 reminds you of waves going back and forth. Now this song's great for beginners. It uses great beginner chords, what we call sometimes cowboy chords. Cowboy chords is just a slang term for the first chord you learn as a guitarist. They only stay in this very basic first position of guitar is what we call it. And cowboy chords utilize as many of the open strings as possible, meaning you don't have to put your finger down for it to ring out. We're gonna keep the strumming very simple. I'm using my thumb and I am just striking downward on the strings. A minor, C, 4, D, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, F, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Back to A minor, C. Now we have this new chord, E. And you can strum the whole guitar. And A minor again, C, D again, F again. And then this is in a ton of traditional songs. A minor, E major, A minor. Listen to that without me talking. Sounds familiar, right? You know, guitar is a right-handed instrument. That means there's more that needs to happen with the right hand. We're gonna be adding a guitar pick, which takes a little getting used to for a beginner. So we're gonna use a very specific rhythm that uses a term called arpeggio. But an arpeggio is when you take a chord and you play the notes individually. So if I strummed an A minor chord, the first chord, it would sound like this. Already more articulation with the pick, but if I make an arpeggio, it sounds like this. What we're gonna do is we're gonna add a strum with an arpeggio in that 3-4, that counting of 3. And so it sounds like this. Now, another thing that kind of is part of that folky, sea chanty vibe is also dragging the pick across the strings for this kind of sound. Cowboy version, I was playing this way, which we as guitar players sometimes refer to as the cheater F. But the full F requires a little more advanced fingering called a bar chord. You can see my index finger is now covering the entire fret, and then with the rest of my fingers, I'm forming a shape. And all together, it sounds like this. So I'm gonna play the rhythm from level 2, but what we're adding now are single notes, phrasing, and melody. So now I'm adding what's called the A minor scale to play the melody of the song over the rhythm. And that's just a set of notes. And then you have to make it musical. There's little articulations and techniques you can add. So one of which is, you know, you got the notes. Right? But what I was doing was I was adding what are called some slides, where you pick one note at one fret and then you slide your finger without picking and you hear it like this. And that imitates the vocal chords a little bit more. And that's also another reason why guitar is popular. The other thing I was doing was vibrato. Just making that note warble a little bit, which is what the human voice does. And you cannot do that on a piano. Now, a looper is a worthy investment, no matter what level of guitar you are. A looper pedal helps your rhythm and your lead chops. And it also is an amazing tool for you to learn how to play in time. So the basic function of a looper is you click it when you want the recording to start, and you click it a second time to create the loop. Look, Mom, no hands. So now, obviously, I'm going to add the melody. You can practice a melody form without being this amazing Jimi Hendrix style lead guitar player. You can just sit and pick out the notes and start to learn them and play them. We're gonna switch up the genre. We're gonna switch instruments. I've got an electric guitar now with an effect called overdrive that gives you that distorted rock sound. I'm also gonna switch these chords to power chords. Every single chord that exists has a power chord version. For instance, I have a full A minor chord. The power chord actually takes some notes away and is only left with this. Those two notes. But when you add that overdrive, it sounds clean but heavy. So now I'm gonna play it in a style like Green Day-ish. And it might sound something like this. So I play all genres of music and I teach all genres of music, but I really like funk and soul music with just a little flavor of jazz. I'm gonna take those basic chords, I'm gonna add a couple of extra colors to them. So instead of a regular A minor, I'll play an A minor 7. Now the other thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play that melody, but I'm now going to improvise with that pool of notes. For this take, I'm going to be using my looper pedal, but I'm also going to be using an overdrive pedal. So I'm going to have a clean guitar sound that's being looped. Then I'm going to turn the overdrive pedal on just for the melody and improvising the single notes and the solo. So you're going to hear a clean guitar in the rhythm, but then when I play lead, I turn that pedal on and now it adds, you know, like a guitar solo type of tone. Thank you. you don't have to follow all the steps I did. No matter your level one or level five, it all starts with the same foundation. And also, you just want to pick up the guitar. Even if it's 5 minutes a day, that's how you get better. You have to pick it up. If you want to check out some more guitar lessons, you can go to my channel, Marty Music on YouTube. I got tons of lessons to help you out. Hope to see you there.